The very best friend. what a glorious way that you. Jill, and I'm sorry didn't notice you there. As you can see, I'm actually packing my things so that I can travel the world to do something very important. But wait, where's my luggage? Oh, I have prepared everything, but I totally forgot my luggage bag. I think this bag is too small to put all this in. And I don't think I can use a plastic bag either to travel. Let's see if Teacher Anna can help me with this problem. Let me send her a text now.
Hello, children! Good morning! What? Teacher Jill is going to text me? How did you know? Huh, wait a minute! I think this must be her. Let me have a look. Hello, Teacher Anna. I need a large luggage bag. Do you have one? I remember I left my luggage at Teacher Jill's house the last time I stayed over. I have not taken it back yet. I think it could probably still at her place. My luggage is still at your place. Maybe you can use it first? I wonder why Teacher Jill needs such a big luggage bag for? Do you think she's going for grocery shopping? It doesn't make sense. If grocery shopping, she needs a trolley instead, isn't it? I know. I think she is planning on a travel. Wait a minute. It cannot be. I don't think she can go on travel. Because we are still have COVID-19 around us.
Oh yes, now I remember. Teacher Anna actually has left her luggage here. It's in the storeroom. Great! Now I can pack my things in the luggage and I'll be ready to go to the airport. So children, you must be wondering why I am packing. It is because I have a very important job to do. I need to travel to Singapore, Paris, Australia, England, and many other places in the world. I want to go and spread God's love to others so that they would know how wide, how long and how deep is his love for the people.
Oh, Teacher Joe, we don't have to travel all around the world to spread God's love. Kids, can you think of ways that we can do that right now? Ha! You are right! We can spread God's love to the people around us by inviting them to praise and worship God, because He wants to be our best friend forever. And in the Bible, it says, "Let everything have breath, praise the Lord." So everyone who is watching this right now, whether you are first time with us or not, let's join in together to sing and dance for Jesus. Come on, let's go!
I know someone who makes me happy. I know someone who makes me dance. He's the reason my feet are moving. He's the reason I'm gonna lift my hands and clap. Clap to the sound. Jump. Jump up and down. Spin. Spin all around. I'm singing. Someone who makes me dance. He's the reason that my feet are moving. He's the reason I'm gonna let my hands and clap. Clap to the sound. Jump. Jump up and down. Spin. Spin all around. I'm singing.
No matter how dark, night or day, God's love helps me not to be afraid. No matter how high a mountain I see, God's love is bigger and it makes me wanna sing. I know no matter what. Tears I may cry, God's love is still here and I'll be alright. And when it's hard to say goodbye, and I just don't want to do it, God's love is what I got, and He will help me through it. I know no matter what, God loves me. 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 And now my hands are clapping, hey! And now my feet are dancing. And God loves you. Say, I know no matter what, God loves me. 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 And now my hands are clapping, hey! And now my feet are dancing.
Was indeed a great praise and worship session. And I'm so happy to know that God's love can be as simple as inviting others to sing and dance together. I guess I can put away all these things now, but talking about spreading God's love, it always reminds me of some different kinds of people. People who are sad and lonely. People who find it difficult to finish their homework. People who are sick. People who are poor and hungry. This was why I wanted to travel around the world to help these people. But, sigh. I cannot travel. I wonder what I can do now.
Children, you know what? The different people that Teacher Jill talk about do not just exist in other countries. We also have people that need God's love in our country. So maybe we all can start by showing God's love and telling people who are living around us that He loves us with the never-ending kind of love. In fact, we have been learning a verse all month long about Jesus' love. So, let's say our verse and do the action together. Ready? How wide? How long? How high? How deep? In the love of Christ. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 18. Now let's do it one more time. Ready? 1, 2, go. How wide? Now, how long? How high? How deep? In the love of Christ. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 18. Now remember this. Jesus loves you and me so much that we can share that love with others. Jesus wants to be our friends forever. So children, are you ready to find out how to share Jesus' love with others? Let's watch this together.
Our true story from the Bible begins with Jesus standing on a mountain. Jesus took his friends up on a mountain after he came back because he had to tell them something very important.
Jesus, you always bring us up to the mountains when you have something important to tell us.
Yes, my lord, please tell us, what is it you have to say?
I have an important job for you. I need you to tell everyone, everywhere, about how much I love them. You need to teach them everything I have taught you. You must let them know that I will always be there for everyone.
Well, how can the 11 of us tell the whole wide world about you?
I know, when we teach people all we have learned about Jesus, we must also teach them how to tell others about Jesus too. And they must also learn how to teach those people to share with others as well.
Oh, so it goes on and on and on and on and on and...
That's right. Let me show you. Everyone spread out. Now, imagine I teach Peter. Jesus loves you and wants to be your friend forever. Now go and tell someone else.
John, Jesus loves you and wants to be your friend forever. Now go and tell someone else.
Thomas, Jesus loves you and wants to be your friend forever. Now go and tell someone else.
Nathaniel, Jesus loves you and wants to be your friend forever. Now go and tell someone else.
That is so cool! So we can teach and tell anyone we know, anyone we meet, anyone we see.
Wow! We can teach or tell anyone we know about Jesus and how He promised to be our friend forever. But does it mean that we don't have to travel around the world in order to spread God's love? We can, actually. We can share God's never-ending love to the people who we meet in different places every day. Isn't it brilliant? We can start sharing His love with our friends and teachers at school, the friends that we played in the playground, our grandma, our grandpa, our uncles and aunties at home. We can also share it to the cashiers in the grocery stores. What else? The waiters in the restaurants. Ding dong! The delivery man. Or even our neighbors. It is such a great promise to also know that Jesus will always be with us when every time we share God's love and tell someone about Him at any time, anywhere. This truly gives us the power to make disciples.
Exactly. So no matter if you're a kid, an adult, an elderly person, if you're a student or a doctor, all of us here today, we can share God's love with others by telling them that Jesus loved them. We can tell the people we know, and they will tell the people they know, and those people will tell the people they know, and it goes on and on and on. Isn't it amazing? This is the wonderful, big and important job that Jesus wants all of us to do. And now, kids, it's your turn to do this big and important job. Now tell me, who can tell anyone, everywhere, that Jesus loves them and wants to be their friend forever. Yes, you can, right? Now, absolutely. All of us here today are called to be the super spreader, to share His love and make disciples. And why we have to do that? Because Jesus loves us so much and He wants to be our friends forever. Now tell me, who wants to be our friend forever? Yes, Jesus wants to be our friend forever. Now, Teacher Jill, can you close in prayer?
So, let's bow down our heads, put our hands together, and close our eyes, and let's ask God to help us to do this very important job, alright? Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for Jesus. We know that He is the best friend ever. Help us share the big news for everyone, everywhere, that Jesus loves us and wants to be our friend forever. We love you, God. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. That's all for this week. And kids, remember to be super spreaders for Jesus. See you at Kids Hangout later.